Hello friends, in last lecture we saw the properties of parallelogram, types of parallelogram, definitions. Okay, now in this lecture we'll see the proof of those properties which are actually theorems. So first I will give you the list of theorems, statements, and then we'll see their proof one by one. So here is the very first proof. You can name the heading theorems. In this first one, okay, now these theorems have a little bit different sequence as given in your book, so do write these theorems. Okay, the very first one is, actually this will be theorem number 2 according to the chapter. In terms of properties, definitely it is the first one, but according to the theorem number, this will start from second, because we already saw the one theorem, that is angle sum property of the quadrilateral. So theorem 2, a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Divides it into two congruent triangles. Next. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Now we have its converse. In a quadrilateral, if opposite sides are equal, then it's a parallelogram. Quadrilateral is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if opposite sides are equal. If its opposite sides are equal. If its opposite sides are equal. Fifth, opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Sixth, converse of fifth, that will be six. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its opposite angles are equal. If its opposite angles are equal. Next, a quadrilateral is a parallelogram. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Next, the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonal parallelogram bisect each other. Ninth, that will be converse of this, that is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its diagonal bisect each other. Quadrilateral is a parallelogram, a quadrilateral parallelogram if its diagonal, if its diagonals bisect each other. Tenth, diagonals of a rectangle are equal. Diagonals diagonals of a rectangle are equal. Okay, next, it's converse. If the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, if diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, it is a rectangle. It is a rectangle. Okay, so note down these 10 theorems, then we'll see remaining theorems. I will give you the statements and then we'll prove one by one. Okay, now next, 12th onward. Okay, next is all angles of a rectangle are equal. All angles of a rectangle are equal. Then 13th, all sides of a rhombus are equal. All sides of a rhombus are equal. Then 14th, if the diagonals of rhombus, diagonals of a rhombus, diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular to each other, are perpendicular to each other. Now we'll see its converse. That means if the diagonals of a quadrilateral are perpendicular to each other, then it's a rhombus. If the diagonals of a parallelogram if the diagonals of a parallelogram, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are perpendicular to each other, are perpendicular to each other, it is a rhombus. It is a rhombus. It is a rhombus. Now, next, diagonals of rhombus bisects the angles at its vertices. Next, 17th, if the diagonals of a parallelogram bisects the angles at its vertices, it is a rhombus. Okay, this 17th one is a converse of 16th. It is a rhombus. Then 18th, all sides of a square are equal. All sides of a square are equal. All sides of a square are equal. All angles and all angles are 90 degree. Then 19th, diagonals of a square are equal and perpendicular to each other, and perpendicular to each other. Then 20th, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal and perpendicular to each other, it is a square. Means 20th is the converse of 19. It is a square. Okay, so note it down. Up to this, we have some more theorems. Okay, so that is, I can say, all theorems related to the parallelogram, that is parallelogram, square, rhombus, rectangle. Now we have four more theorems, and they are related to the trapezium. If you remember, there were two properties of the isosceles trapezium. So there are four theorems, two directly and two the converse. So after this, we have four more theorems. Okay, now let us see the next theorems. We have four more theorems, and these four upcoming theorems are related to the isosceles trapezium. So, 21st, diagonals of an isosceles trapezium, diagonals of an isosceles trapezium are equal. Okay, diagonals of an isosceles trapezium are equal. If the diagonals of a trapezium, now it's converse, if the diagonals of a trapezium, if the diagonals of a trapezium are equal, it is isosceles. It is isosceles. Then next, angles on either side of the parallel sides of an isosceles trapezium are equal. Okay, and last is the converse of this 23rd. That means if the angles on either side of a parallel side of a trapezium are equal, it is isosceles. If angles on either side of the parallel sides of a trapezium are equal, it is isosceles. Okay, so these all are the theorems. Now there are two more theorems actually, but they are little bit different from these two, the midpoint theorem and the converse midpoint theorem. So that we'll see after completing these theorems, then the questions related to these theorems, then we come to the midpoint theorem. So note it down, then we'll start the questions based on these theorems. Sorry, then we'll start the proof of these theorems. Okay, now we'll see the proof of the theorems one by one. As I do some proof I will give you over here and some you will get for your homework. Okay, so it is the very first theorem of this lecture, actually theorem number 2. Diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay, so what we have given, a parallelogram. Okay, this is a parallelogram we have given with, and it is given that one of its diagonal we can say is given. Okay, so okay, so this is a parallelogram we have. Let the parallelogram is ABCD. So what we have given, theorem says a diagonal parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. So given parallelogram ABCD that we have given, parallelogram ABCD and AC is its diagonal, and AC is its diagonal that we have to give, that we have given. Okay, what we have to prove, if AC is the diagonal that we have given, so we have to prove that these two triangles are congruent. That means we have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CAD. Triangle CDA. Triangle CDA. Okay, that we have to prove these two triangles are congruent. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. Okay, so as I told you that if you know the congruency, it means you know the proof of the theorems. So simply we can say this particular theorem has no relation with this chapter actually. The only thing that is connected is the properties. Otherwise this is a pure question of a congruency. Simply you have to prove these two triangles are congruent. So it's very easy. Let me give you the proof. See, AD equal to BC, AB equal to DC. Why AD equal to BC? Because in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Similarly, AB equal to DC, again the reason, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. AC is the common side. So simply I can write in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and triangle CDA, and triangle CDA, AB is equal to CD, BC is equal to AD. For this reason, in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal, or I can write opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, and AC equal to AC, that is common. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA. Triangle CDA by SSS. Hence, proof. Okay, so note it down. Then we'll see the next theorem. Okay, in next we have to prove opposite sides are equal. Okay, one thing you have to keep in your mind that while proving one theorem, you are allowed to use any other theorem, not the same theorem. Okay, by leaving that particular theorem, you can use any other theorem. Second theorem or the next theorem says opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. So we have given ABCD is a parallelogram ABCD. To prove what we have to prove, opposite sides are equal. That means we have to prove AB equal to CD and, okay, we have to prove for the next theorem AB equal to CD and BC equal to AD. And BC equal to AD, that we have to prove. So again we have to prove these two sides are equal as well as these two sides are equal. For that we need to prove these two triangles congruent. So definitely we'll start with the same triangles. Now how to prove the triangles congruent? See, over there we proved as by SSS. Now here we can't use that side. Why? Because we have to prove DC equal to AB, so we can't take DC equal to AB as the given information. Similarly, we have to prove AD equal to BC, so we can't use AD equal to BC as the given information. But it is sure that if we prove these two triangles congruent by CPCT, we can say AB equal to CD, BC equal to AD. So think about any other congruency criteria that you can use to prove these two triangles congruent. Triangle ABC, triangle CDA. See, this angle if I say 1 and this angle if I say 2, this 3, this 4. So I can say angle 1 equal to angle 2. Why? Alternate interior angle, because AB is parallel to CD. Similarly, 3, 4 is equal to 3, again because AD is parallel to BC. So here I can write angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Reason I will write alternate interior angles as AB parallel CD. Now from where we got that AB is parallel to CD? Because it's a parallelogram, and in a parallelogram opposite sides are parallel. It's the definition of the parallelogram. Now AC equal to AC, that I can take common, and then angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Better to write angle 4 equal to angle 3, as I told you in the congruency, as I'm taking triangle ABC first, so I will take the part of this triangle first. So 4 equal to 3, again the reason is alternate interior angles. Why? Which lines are parallel? I can say BC parallel AD, as BC parallel AD. So therefore I can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by angle side angle. Therefore I can say, what I can say, AB equal to CD and BC equal to, BC is equal to AD or DA. Reason CPCT, hence proof. So note it down, then we'll see the next theorem. Okay, now next theorem number 4, which is converse of this. That means a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its opposite sides are equal. So here it is given ABCD is a quadrilateral. Given ABCD is a quadrilateral in which we have AB equal to CD, in which AB equal to CD and BC equal to AD. To prove quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here it is given ABCD is a quadrilateral in which we have, it is given AB is equal to CD and these are equal. Okay, I'm taking out these two. So now here you have to prove ABCD is a parallelogram. Now to prove a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, what are the basic things that we need to prove? See, we saw all these theorems over there. If you remember, there was a theorem that in a quadrilateral, if diagonal bisects each other, it's a parallelogram. Or in a quadrilateral, if one pair of opposite side is equal, see theorem number 7, if you have noted down the theorems, see theorem number 7, it says in a quadrilateral, if one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel, it's a parallelogram. So here, if it is possible to prove that AB equal to CD, which is already, so our only target is to prove that AB parallel CD. If we are able to prove these two sides are parallel, we can say it's a parallelogram. Okay, so although this is a property that in a quadrilateral if opposite sides are equal is, then it's a parallelogram, but here we are proving that theorem only, so we won't use that theorem. We have to use any other theorem. We can also use that if both pair of opposite sides are parallel, then again it's a parallelogram. That is the definition. So here there are two ways to prove this is a parallelogram. Either if I prove AB parallel CD, because AB equal to CD, so I can say it's a parallelogram, or if I prove AB parallel CD as well as AD parallel BC, that means if I use the property, sorry, definition of the parallelogram, which says both pair of opposite sides are parallel. So if I show that this quadrilateral has both pair of opposite sides parallel, then again I can say it's a parallelogram. But obviously it will take more time. Here only target is to prove AB parallel CD, and otherwise I need to prove both pairs. So definitely it will take less time if I prove only one pair of opposite sides parallel. Now second thing, how to prove the given lines are parallel, that we saw in our previous chapter, that is lines and angles, not in the triangle, in the lines and angles. How to prove lines are parallel? Either we prove the alternate interior angles are equal, or if we prove corresponding angles are equal, or if we prove sum of the interior angles on the same side of the transversal is 180, or if I prove the alternate exterior angles are equal. So to prove the lines parallel, we have to show one of these four things. So I am trying to prove angle 1 equal to 2. If I say angle 1 equal to 2, then here we can see 1 and 2 are 1 and 2 form a pair of alternate interior angles. So as soon as I show 1 equal to 2, I can conclude AB parallel DC, and also it is given AB equal to CD. That means one pair of opposite side of this quadrilateral will be equal as well as parallel, so definitely it will be a parallelogram. So now my target is to prove angle 1 equal to angle 2. Now how to prove angle 1 equal to 2? Again, if I say if it is possible to prove these two triangles congruent, I can say angle 1 equal to 2 CPCT. So let us see how we can say these triangles are congruent. See, AB equal to DC, it is given, BC equal to AD, it is given, and AC common. So we can say these two triangles are congruent by side. As soon as the triangles are congruent, 1 equal to 2 by CPCT. So we'll start with the same thing, that we'll prove the triangles are congruent. Okay, so in triangle ABC and triangle CDA, AB equal to CD, BC equal to AD, both I can say are the given conditions, and AC equal to AC, that is common. Therefore I can say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by side. Okay, these two triangles are congruent by side. Therefore I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by CPCT. But these angles form a pair of alternate interior angles with transversal AC by transversal AC by transversal AC with AB and CD with AB and CD. Therefore, AB parallel CD. Let it be second or first. Let it be AB equal to CD. Or let it be second. Let AB equal to CD. This was 1. Okay. From 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, 1 pair of opposite side, or I can write from 1 and 2, AB parallel CD and AB equal to CD. Thus, quadrilateral ABCD has one pair of opposite side equal and parallel. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Hence, proof. Okay, here we concluded that one pair of opposite side is equal and parallel. So it's a parallelogram. Note it down. Okay, so that was actually theorem number 4th. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if opposite sides are equal. Now, theorem number 5, 6, 7th, that is for your homework. Okay, theorem number 5, 6, 7, that definitely I will send you in the PDF. Theorem number 5, 6, 7 for your homework. Now, we'll see theorem number 8, that is the diagonal. Parallelogram, the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, that is theorem number 8 that we will see right now. Theorem number 8. Diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, so we have a parallelogram and we have to prove its diagonals bisect each other. Okay, so we have parallelogram ABCD given quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram, diagonals AC and BD meet at O. Meet at O to prove, okay. Diagonal AC and BD meet at O to prove they bisect each other. To prove AO equal to CO and BO is equal to DO. Okay, bisect each other means you have to prove AO and CO are equal and BO and DO are equal. That you have to prove. Okay, so think for a while that how will you prove this? See, we can prove it by angle-angle side or angle side angle. We have to prove this. So if I prove these two triangles congruent, I can say AO equal to CO and BO equal to DO. Now to prove these two triangles congruent, this one information I have directly, that is AD equal to BC. I can say angle 1 equal to angle 2 at interior angles because AD parallel BC, and angle 3 equal to angle 4 again by alternate interior angles as AD parallel BC. So by angle side angles we can say triangles are congruent. Or if I say this angle DOA or BOC are also equal. So if I don't want to use angle 3 and 4, if I use these two angles vertically opposite angles, then I can say these triangles will be congruent by angle-angle side. So let us see its proof. See, this is the fourth theorem that I am solving over here, and if you are observing, in each and every theorem what we need? Congruency. So congruency is very 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 important. I am again repeating that if still you are not that serious with the congruency, revise that chapter, because even in the next chapter and in the circles we need congruency too much. Okay, so now in triangle AOD, in triangle AOD and triangle COB, and triangle COB, I can write angle 1 is equal to angle 2, reason alternate interior angles as AD parallel BC, as AD parallel BC. Then AD equal to BC, AD equal to BC, I can say given, as I didn't write that thing in given, so I will write opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, because opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Then angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Why angle 3 equal to angle 4? Same reason, that is alternate interior, alternate interior angles. Why? Because AD parallel BC, as AD parallel BC. Therefore triangle AOD is congruent to triangle COB by angle side angle, and hence I can say AO equal to CO and OD equal to OB, and OD is equal to OB. Hence prove, reason by CPCT, as the triangles are congruent, corresponding parts will be equal. Please note it down. okay, now it's converse. That means in a quadrilateral, if diagonal bisect each other, then it's a parallelogram. That means over there it is given AO equal to CO, BO equal to DO, so you have to prove it's a parallelogram. I'm giving you its solution in short. See, AO equal to CO given, BO equal to DO given. You can take these two vertically opposite angles equal, so triangles will be congruent, 1 equal to 2. So AD parallel BC. Similarly, also, okay, AD parallel BC. Similarly, you can say DC parallel AB. So both pair of opposite sides will be parallel, so it will be a parallelogram. So that is again for your homework. Okay, now next theorem is the diagonals of a rectangle are equal. That is again for your homework. I will give you its converse. That means in a quadrilateral, if diagonals equal, then it's a parallelogram. Okay, in if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then it's a then it's a rectangle. That we will see. Next theorem is theorem number 11. Then that I am going to solve here for you. If the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, theorem number 11, okay, if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then it's a rectangle, theorem number 11, not as per the book, the sequence I gave you, according to that theorem number 11. It is quite possible that sequence that I gave you and the sequence which is in the book may match somewhere, but it is not necessary that it will match throughout. Concentrate on the sheet that I gave you, theorem number 11. What it says, we have to prove that if the diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then it's a rectangle. So given ABCD is a parallelogram, given ABCD is a parallelogram with or in which AC equal to BD, diagonals are equal, BD it is equal to AC, that is given, and you have to prove that it's a rectangle. To prove ABCD is a rectangle. Okay, so to prove any quadrilateral or any parallelogram, it is already given. To prove it's a rectangle, you should know the definition of the rectangle. What it says, a parallelogram having one angle is called rectangle. So if it is possible to prove one of its angle is 90 degree, we can say it will be a rectangle. So we'll try to prove one of its angle is 90 degree. See, this is given, this AD is, we know AD is parallel to BC, isn't it? This AD is parallel to BC. It means sum of these two angles. That means angle A, for a while, if I remove these diagonals, angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degree, isn't it? Now, if I prove these two angles are equal, if anyhow I am able to prove these two angles are equal, sum of these two is 90 degree, and each and these two angles are equal, then each will be 90 degree. Okay, so now my target is to prove this angle A, that is DAB, is equal to this angle B, that is angle ABC. So for that, if I take this triangle, okay, triangle DAB and CBA, triangle DAB, in triangle DAB and triangle CBD or triangle ABC, in triangle DAB and triangle CBA. So AD equal to BC because it's a parallelogram, AB is common, and this AC equal to BD, that is given. So we can say these two triangles will be congruent by side. Okay, so here can write DA is equal to BC. Reason, opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Okay, then AB is equal to BA, that is common, and then BD is equal to AC, that is given. Therefore, I can say triangle DAB is congruent to triangle CBA by side, and hence I can say angle DAB, therefore angle DAB is equal to angle DAB is equal to angle ABC is equal to angle ABC. Let this be first one by CPCT. Now AD parallel BC, therefore angle DAB, plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. Reason, co-interior angles, or I can say the same side of the triangle. So here I am writing co-interior angles. Okay. Therefore angle ABC plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degree. Now here what I wrote, I replaced AB by ABC. Why? Because it is in the one, or we proved in the one. DAB, angle DAB is equal to angle ABC from first. Okay. Therefore, I can write twice angle ABC is equal to 180 degree, and hence angle ABC is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So now we can say ABCD is a parallelogram. Here I can write thus quadrilateral ABCD, or simply thus ABCD is a parallelogram having one angle 90 degree. Therefore, ABCD is a rectangle. Hence proof. Okay, so please note it down. So I hope this proof is clear to you. Okay, I'm giving you explanation of this once again. In short, here it was ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, and it is also given that its diagonals are equal. So we have to prove it's a rectangle. So first of all, for that you must know the definition of rectangle. It says that a parallelogram having one angle 90 degree is a rectangle. So to prove this parallelogram is a rectangle, we need to prove one of its angle is 90 degree. So I started by thinking that AD and BC are parallel, so these two angles are supplementary. Now I need to prove one angle is 90 degree, so for that these two angles must be equal because their sum is 180. If both will be equal, then each will be 90. So now next thing I thought ki how to make these two angles equal, but obvious congruency. So now I selected two triangles that contains these two angles, that is angle A in short and angle B, that is angle ABC and angle DAB. So now to prove these two triangles, first I use AD equal to BC, which is given. Why it is given? Because it's a parallelogram, and in a parallelogram opposite sides are equal. Then BC, which is common, and it is given AC equal to BD. So I proved the triangles are congruent by side, and as the triangles are congruent, I can write angle DAB equal to angle ABC by CPCT. Now I came to the concept of co-anterior angles. The lines are parallel, so their sum will be 180 degree. Then I replace DAB equal to ABC, twice of ABC equal to 180, that gives me ABC equal to 90. So thus I got a parallelogram. I have a parallelogram ABCD in which one angle is 90 degree, so definitely it is a rectangle. So thus ABCD is a parallelogram having one angle 90 degree, so it's a parallelogram. So that is all about today's lecture. Now in next lecture we'll continue with some more theorems. Till then, bye, thank you, take care, stay at home.